Back here at the Car Show in Hickory, I'm Wesley Outland, and joining me is Jeremiah Reed from Otho, Iowa. He was not once, but a two-time winner for Crate Insider, Superior Bearings, and Daytona One, who's a proud sponsor of the Cars Racing Show. Welcome aboard.
Thank you.
And you also race front-wheel drive cars up in...
Sport Mods.
Sport Mods, okay, yeah, Sport Mod cars. But they're crate engines, right?
Yeah.
I got you. Yep. Talk about your racing career and a little bit of a background about you, Jeremiah.
Well, from Iowa. Basically, I've been there my whole life for the most part. Started in drag racing, actually. Did that for about 10 years, and then 2 years ago, I made the switch to dirt. Started in a sport modified and kind of still there. You know, obviously, 2 years, I'm still learning. Always learning. You always learn.
Different world from straight line go fast to turning left and sometimes slinging it right, right?
Yep, definitely. It's a lot more of a challenge than I thought it'd be. You know, originally starting, you know, sitting in the stands, you're like, I can't be that hard to turn left, but it is. So, you know, it's a lot harder than it looks. There's some challenges setup-wise and stuff. You got to learn all that stuff. So, you know.
So how did you sign up to win these contests? Not once, but two with Crate Insider and Kate Dillon.
The first one with Superior Bearing and Supply, I kind of just happened to chance upon it on Facebook and saw it. And I was like, you know what, I'll enter it, see what happens. And, you know, just happened to be the lucky one they pulled out. And, you know, when Kate called me, she said, you know, having a YouTube channel was one of the big factors that made a difference in their decision. If you guys want to follow us on YouTube, Breed Racing, and then we ended up winning the Daytona One challenge as well, which really didn't expect that one. We got to top four, and I was like, okay, that's cool. Didn't expect that, you know. And then down to the last four, and so we kind of, you know, made a push with our fans, and our fans, you know, basically got us the most votes. So appreciate them for doing that, and you know, won both of them. Kind of the first things I've won in my life. So
that's awesome. Okay. It's awesome. So Kate Dillon and Crate Insider might be your good luck charm for sure.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, the first thing I did when I came in here was I thanked her. So,
So being from the Buckeye State of Iowa and Hawkeye State, I've done it again. Buckeye State is Ohio. Hawkeye State is Iowa. But being from the Hawkeye State, normally Indianapolis, PRI would be where everybody goes to. What's your take of coming all the way down to North Carolina to the Tar Heel State and experiencing the car show?
It's, you know, we kind of made a trip out of it. Took some extra time off work. We're going to, you know, just kind of enjoy it while we're here. I've been in North Carolina a few times. I actually, at one point in my life, I thought about moving down here. I was, before I started getting into dirt track racing, I was actually interested in a career working, you know, as an engineer in NASCAR or something. And obviously that's bigger out here. So I went to school and got my engineering degree. And then kind of about the time I graduated, it was about the time I got into a dirt car. And I was like, you know, being in Iowa, that's as far as, you know, modifieds and stuff that I race, that's kind of the biggest area as far, you know, within an hour of my track or within an hour of my house, there's six tracks that we can race at.
Yeah, I was going to say that. What are the tracks that you run at in Iowa?
So my closest track, just 5 miles down the road, is Sports Park Raceway in Fort Dodge, Iowa. And then we also have Webster City, Hamilton County Speedway. They're about 20 miles down the road. Boone's 45 minutes from us. We got Britt, Alta.
Ever been to the Super Nationals
at
Boone, Iowa?
The last 2 years.
That's grueling, isn't it?
It's a test, that's for sure. I mean, you know, the nice thing about it is if you break something, you got plenty of time to fix it because there's so many cars there.
Yeah.
But it's definitely different than just your weekly race because when you go out there, you have to be ready.
And I think the cool thing about the Super Nationals is like, you know, it's a race, it's an event, but it's a party.
Yes.
I mean, like, you literally have one night where you're literally, that's your specific night that you are racing. And then the other days, you're just hanging out and hanging with the boys and the girls and the wife and everyone else and just enjoying things.
Yeah, we race Monday, Tuesday usually. And then if we're not in and we're high in points, we'll race Wednesday. And then we're off till Saturday. So we got, you know, whether we make it in or not, we still got 2 or 3 days to party there and have fun.
And that's got to be fun to have that enjoyment of knowing that you've got six tracks within your vicinity that you can go run at. And that's one of the things I love about Northeast racing and the Midwest as well. You know, if you are a diehard race car driver and you want to be in the racing industry, you could literally go to a track every day of the week, maybe off on a certain day, but you could race every day of the week. And that's one of the cool things I like about being up in the Northeast or the Midwest for racing, because down south, South. I don't know who put that primarily Friday, Saturday, status on racetracks here in the South. But up north, in where you're at in Iowa, you could run every day of the week, literally.
Yep, most of the time almost all the tracks are Wednesday through Sunday.
Yeah.
But there's specials on Mondays and Tuesdays, so you can especially during the middle of summer, you could race every day of the month.
Yes, for sure. And a lot of people ask me that question. They say, why do they do that? Well, the reason why is they don't have a lot of warm weather. You know, they literally start up around the end of April, beginning of May, and you got to be done by September, by October, because it gets cold.
There's a few specials, late March, early April. There's a few specials. Then you kind of, after the specials are over, then you kind of wait till the end of April before anything really starts. And then most season championships are done in August sometime. You'll have specials in September and October, or Super Nationals in September. You get a lot of racing in a short time, because after that it gets too cold. And, when it gets cold enough, the dirt just doesn't hold up like it does during the summer. So
one more question for you. We're Jeremiah Reed here at the Cars Show. What are you taking from this Cars Show experience to take back to Iowa for your 2020 season?
A lot of it's, just meeting people and getting to know the people in the industry. So, if I need, I see KRC over there, if I need something from KRC, putting a face to a name and if I need something, I can contact them and say, hey, I talked to you at the show, looking for this part, what do you got?
Definitely. Well, hey, look, in closing, how can they follow Jeremiah Reed Racing? Do you have your own personal page?
Yep. So we have a Facebook page. It's just facebook.com/Reed Racing. We also have Instagram. It's kind of the same thing, instagram.com/Reed Racing. We got our YouTube channel, which is Reed Racing. Short link is that. But if you go on any of our social media, you'll be able to find the other ones, because they're all linked in some sort. So.
Awesome, bud. Thank you. From Othello, Ohio, Jeremiah Reed here at the Cars Show. I'm Wesley Outland, Hickory, North Carolina, and keep an eye on him in the Hawkeye State in 2021.